Microsoft Copilot in Excel has an awesome new feature. It can create files for you. I am Chris Menard. Let's dive into this feature right now. Already on my screen is Excel. I am in Excel on the web. This is web only right now. This employee spreadsheet or table that I have, Microsoft Copilot created it. So let me just show you what I did to do this. File, new file, and let's do a blank workbook. Copilot dialog box starts immediately. Describe the tasks you'd like Copilot to help with. Down below are suggested prompts. Click on the arrow to the right, you will see more prompts right here. Let me do yearly income expense tracker in USD, but before I do that one, let me just look through and show you a couple others that they have down here in the bottom. Perfect. And by the way, if you don't see something you want that's being suggested with a prompt, click in the box and type it. We'll try that one next. Let's do yearly income and expense tracker. It puts it in the prompt box, send it off. Copilot is going to create a table, and I like working in tables, especially in Copilot. Microsoft has said that when you're using Copilot, your data can be in a range now. I have found that tables still work much better with Copilot than a range. The keyboard shortcut, if you have a range to make a table, is Control and the letter T. It's also on the Insert tab if you're a mouse person, Insert Table. By default, I am telling Copilot to include sample data to help me understand it. I could remove that check mark. I am looking through here. There's January through December, planned income, actual income, planned expenses, actual. This is looking great. This difference, just to click on this, I'm in cell F2. It is showing me the difference with the planned income minus the actual, and it's showing me the names because I have this in a table and not a range. There's table design at the top, by the way. The expense difference, and finally, net savings. I like this. I'm going to go ahead and hit keep it. Copilot launches over here to the right. By the way, I could have in the prompt box before I said keep it, I could have told it to add a column. Let's go look at one more example with that. Another file, new. I'm going to go back to the employee one that I showed you to begin with because I actually did that. Employee directory in blue theme with bold names. Just to test this, I showed you the blue theme to begin with. Let's go with the green theme and highlight the email column and last name. I'm just making this up. Let's see if this works. Fingers are crossed. Again, Copilot's going to go and run and create a table for us. And it highlighted the last name and it highlighted the email address. Here is my example when you can continue here. I have on my screen in this table, zoom in on it just a tad. I have the employee ID, the names, the departments, the email, and the phone. I would like to know what is their office location. Add office location. And put it between last name and department. Send that off. Copilot will create the table again from scratch. It keeps the same information. I do see office location right in between last name and department. This is working great. I'm going to click on keep it. Those emails that are on the screen are fictitious emails that were created by Copilot. Those are not real emails, just to be clear about that. I'm really impressed with this feature. I appreciate your time. My Copilot training courses are available online along with Teams, Excel, and OneNote. Have a great day. I appreciate your time. I appreciate you subscribing to my channel and all the support you've given me. Thank you.